Okay, I'm assuming everyone can simplify this. Everyone can simplify this, am I right? So we'll get started with the steps. So from this juncture onwards, I'm going to show you quotient rule, then I'm going to show you product rule. You can choose if you want to. Okay? Because I know at the end of the day, some of you will definitely be more comfortable with product rule. But I'm showing it because I want to show you the answer must be the same. Okay, we're going to use quotient rule first. If I want to use the quotient rule, I differentiate the top, keep the bottom. Minus, okay, whenever I need to differentiate terms they are a little bit more difficult, I tell myself I have to be very, very and careful. Differentiate the bottom. Brandon, how to differentiate the bottom?
Bring down power down.
Bring down the power. One third minus one is negative two thirds. Done already? You will get
two.
Okay, keep the top. Over the bottom square. Power one third, you square it again. What do you do to the power? Two third, because you multiply the power together. Same as what we did previously, we need to take out the common term over here. I mean, what are the common terms at the numerator? Any more? Power what? Okay, between one third and negative two third, always take out the smaller power. Any other common term? Okay, so you can see there's a 2 here, so I take out the common term 2. If you don't want, it's okay, but you need to do something later, alright? I take out the common term 2 first. Now, I need to put whatever I did not take out inside the square bracket. Xingyue, what will be inside the square bracket? 2x minus 5. Okay, this will be to the power of 1, am I right? We all agree yesterday already. The one that is bigger, once you take it out, the power will always be 1 because the difference is 1. Minus 1 third. Okay, thank you. Over the bottom. Now, this is not as easy as the previous one. Can you see, obviously, everyone can simplify the square bracket. But can you see both the numerator and denominator has a common term? And it's not so simple to simplify anymore. Okay, so please look here, everybody. Do you think you would like to simplify the denominator to become the numerator, or numerator to bring it down to the denominator? Which will be a better choice? Why numerator bring down to become the denominator? Yes, because we want positive indices if possible. Okay, we will want positive indices if possible. Now, if you learned previously, have you seen this before? If I want to do division, agree? All agree, yeah? But now, this can also be written, if I wanted everything at the denominator, this is seen as x to the power of b, x to the power of negative a. Agree? Then what do you do to the power when they're the same way? You will add together. So this will become, I'm going to apply this concept. Obviously, the change of the sign of the power, everyone knows. But when they are of the same base, you add the indices together, okay? So I'm going to make use of this concept now. Now, this is negative. When you bring it down, the power becomes positive. 2/3. Add to another 2/3. How many are there? 4/3. Now, we just need to simplify the terms inside the bracket. Can we leave our answer this way? What must we do? Andy, what must we do? Times 3 on top. You also need to multiply by 3 below. Okay? Multiply by 3 on top. Multiply by 3 below. Okay, now I want to come in again. This answer is already very good. But for the purpose of solving question, I can further simplify my power 4/3 to be something else. Instead of writing as a power 4/3, when you have 4/3, don't take a look at the power 4 first. Take a look at the over 3. Over 3 will mean cube root, not square root, cube root. So do the cube root first. Then after that, what do you do to the power 4? You make it to the power of 4. Okay, why do I want to write this? Because when you do your solving, it's actually easier. But there's nothing wrong in just writing the one in. Okay, but the one in red will allow you to do your solving slightly easier. Okay? Okay, this is the most tedious question you can get in a quotient book. This is the most tedious already. You cannot get more tedious than this. Now, don't try this first. After you have copied this down, what I want you to do, can we use the product rule to do this question? I'd like you to try that. Use product rule to do this question. And you see which one suits you better, then you will know. But you will still need to use quotient rule. Because certain questions, quotient rules are faster. I mean, careless mistake where? Oh, 4x. Thank you. Okay, now, can I give you 5 minutes? After you have done this, go and use the product rule to do this question and see if you get the same answer. Alright, product rule.